Today we're going to talk a little about Tassel applications in corn. So this could be anything from fungicide to insecticide, biologicals, or as we call them, natural products, maybe even some foliar fertilizer. What can you do and what should you do on your farm?
Well, certainly at tasseling time, one of the things you're going to hear the most about is fungicide application. After this point, we have more issues historically with gray leaf spot, northern corn leaf blight, and a number of other diseases across the country. So if you want to protect your corn, you need to be out in front of that with a fungicide application. Now here's a couple of things that I would mention. You've got a big tall corn plant now. It's reached its maximum height once you've hit that tassel stage. So you're looking at a lot of leaf area. Do you really need to cover the entire plant from top to bottom? I would argue, no you don't. At this point, you probably just want to make sure you're covering down to the ear leaf, but that's going to be a little ways down into the canopy. Those leaves from the ear leaf and up are really going to be important in determining your yield. So do check what's going on with your coverage to see how deep in the plant you're getting.
The biggest problem I have with spraying a fungicide this late in the season is it costs a lot of money. You have to use the full rate. You're going to have to bring in either a plane or a high boy or something to get over the top of that tall crop. Is it going to pay for itself? In our geography in the Western Corn Belt, typically it does not. When it does, is when we have a lot more rainfall. So the last 2 years we've had record rains in our region, and when we sprayed fungicide it was phenomenal. I mean there was no question that was the absolute best thing we could possibly do. There are other areas of the country like Illinois, Iowa, Indiana, where we see tassel applications pay almost all the time, and the reason why is those diseases Darren mentioned. It's some terrible diseases that we fortunately don't typically face here in the Western Corn Belt. Things like the northern corn leaf blight and gray leaf spot. Anyway, with fungicide applications at tassel, our advice to you is make sure you're using multiple modes of action, and again, use the full rate. There are new products out like Veltima, let's just say, from BASF. Trivapro's been out for about 3-4 years now. Multiple mode of action products are the way to go. That way you beat resistance, you've got a more broad spectrum in terms of control, and we do kind of like having a strobe in there too, just because you can hopefully get some plant health benefits. And by strobe, I mean a strobilurin like Headline, Quadra, Sevito.
Now the challenge here is the crop is big enough, many operations aren't able to do that with equipment that they've got. They aren't able to do the application, so they're going to hire in a helicopter or an airplane or something like that. If you're doing that, you may be thinking, wow, I'm going to have to pay that guy $8 an acre or $10 an acre. I want to try and get as much done as I can. So how about considering some other options? One of the questions that we get a lot is, hey, should I just throw an insecticide in there? I'm already out spraying a fungicide. I've done that on soybeans historically and it's worked well for me because I generally have some soybean aphids or other pests out there. How about in corn? Well, I would say the exact same thing that I would say in soybeans or alfalfa or any other crop. If you're going to spray an insecticide, scout first. Get out in the field, take a look, see if there are any harmful insects. If there are no harmful insects in the field at all, there's no way I would recommend spraying an insecticide. However, if there are even low levels of harmful insects out there, like corn leaf aphids, for example, or if you see, hey, I'm starting to see some egg masses, great. Add the insecticide into the package. There are a lot of good products that can be used. They're going to have some residual for the next few weeks.
I love how when Darren said, you see insect egg masses, great. I'm going, what? That's not great at all. If you're already out there spraying a fungicide and you can throw an insecticide in though, that absolutely does help because now you don't have that extra cost for application. I would also tell you, consider throwing in a foliar fertilizer. That's what we do whenever we're going to make a tassel application. And again, we're not going to do it every year in our geography. It doesn't always pay. We will pick the wetter years. That's when we found it has paid well to spray the fungicide. Then if we have harmful insects, sure, we're going to throw insecticide in. But in terms of this foliar fertilizer, should you throw it in or not, I would tell you do pre-side dress nitrate tests or a soil test shortly before tassel. Also, do plant tissue analysis all throughout the growing season. And if you're finding that, hey, week after week, I'm a little bit short on boron or I'm a little short on nitrogen or sulfur, then by all means, throw in just a little bit of that. You don't need a whole lot to get a little bit of yield gain. You haven't spent a lot of money. Hopefully that gives you a good ROI, especially when, in effect, the application cost is free. That money's already spent because you're out there spraying something else.
Now you may also be considering putting in some sort of natural product. And Brian had mentioned nitrogen there. We hear a lot of different products out on the market today of things that could help bring more nitrogen into the plant. Now if you're looking to get higher test weight, higher protein in grain, these types of things, it helps to have nitrogen and sulfur available late in the season for that crop. So if you see, you know what, I can put a little nitrogen on now, but maybe I've got a light soil, or maybe I'm in a high rainfall area and I'm not sure that all that nitrogen's gonna stick around, maybe consider a natural for enhancing your nitrogen uptake or your nitrogen production. There's a lot of different products out there like Anhydro, and we hear of others. You can certainly do that at this timing as well. That'd be another thing where you just have to figure out what that product is, what they need to make it work, like good coverage, for example, and a proper amount of carrier to make that happen.
Okay, so once again, Tassel applications in corn absolutely can pay. It's just if we're talking fungicide, if you're not in an area of the country that has a lot of disease pressure, you're gonna have to look at what's my weather doing. If you've got a wetter year, we would tell you the odds are much better that fungicide's going to pay. In a real dry year, probably not so much. On top of that, take a look at insecticide, potentially throwing in the tank, foliar fertilizer, and maybe even a biological or natural product.
One thing that you're not taking care of though with a corn tasseling application is weed control. We'll show you what will stop this weed and when to do it coming up later in the show.